He just walked into my salon and said that he worked for a credit card processing company.
A man with a history of stalking women is behind bars less than a day after several women reported having run-ins with him. Good evening, everyone. Thanks for joining us for Fox 16 News at 5:30. I'm Donna Terrell.
I'm Kevin Kelly. Fox 16 Susan El-Khoury joining us in studio. And Susan, based on your story and what we've talked about, it's a pretty scary situation.
Yeah, Kevin and Donna, this is who we're talking about, Jeffrey Hergert. He was convicted last year for harassing a woman in Conway and was back in Faulkner County yesterday, arrested on a parole violation. I talked to one woman today who had a recent run-in with him.
At Electric Avenue Hair Salon, cleanup is constant for Kara Pickett. But when Jeffrey Hergert walked in the front door, she knew something wasn't right.
It's an unsettling feeling whenever you're around him.
And it escalated when he wouldn't go away.
It was just a three-day process of him just not going away at all.
She says Hergert kept harassing her at work.
Sits on my couch for an hour, hour and a half, and just watches me and my coworkers work.
She now has a restraining order against him. We've learned he has a felony record for stalking women and faces similar charges in three other states. Plus, just got a new mugshot in Faulkner County.
It's good that we got the calls. You know, that's how we got them stopped and at least got him out of town.
Hergert was picked up on a parole violation the day after police in Vilonia were called by a teenage clerk at this gas station who says the 44-year-old kept asking her on a date.
It's scary by the background. His background is what really has got everybody really scared, and maybe rightfully so.
Just keep suggesting things, and like when you have something to say to tell him to go away, he has another comeback.
But this hairstylist picked up enough to know she doesn't want to take any chances.
He's barred from this business completely.
Hergert was arrested but hasn't been charged with this recent parole violation. He's faced stalking charges in three other states, Pennsylvania, Nevada, and South Carolina. Back to you. All right.